Hello again. Today we start our next topic, linear codes. Linear codes are used for transmitting bits on the communication channels so that if errors occur, they can be detected by the recipient of a message and, if possible, corrected. In linear codes, as you know, as in all other detection and correction codes, additional bits are required to code the message. These bits are called redundant, check, or parity bits. A linear code of length n transmits block containing n symbols. For example, the Hamming code 743 is a linear code which represents four bit messages using 7-bit code words. This code contains 2^4 16 valid code words. In general, if we have NKM code word length M N equals 2^(m-1), number of information bits K should be equal to 2^(m-1), number of parity bits M equals N minus K. Minimum distance to detect D errors, should be greater than or equal to D+1, and minimum distance to correct D errors should be greater than or equal to 2D+1. Code efficiency is defined as K over N, or after manipulation, efficiency equals to 1 minus m over 2^(m-1). And it's a measurement of redundancy. For example, the Hamming code 743, the efficiency is 4/7. In the 743 Hamming code, any two code words differ in at least 3 bits. The distance is 3. As a consequence, up to 2 errors per code word can be detected, while only one single error can be corrected. And again, to detect C errors, the distance should be greater than or equal to C+1, and to correct C errors, the distance should be greater than or equal to C+1. A linear code of length n, dimension k, and distance d is called NKD code. The weight of a code word is the number of its elements that are non-zero. For example, the weight for 101100 equals to 3, number of ones. The distance between two code words is the Hamming distance between them, the number of elements in which they differ. For example, the distance between 11010, 10001 11010 10001, they differ in 1, 2, 3 positions. Or if we add by mod 2 exclusive OR, we have 3 ones. This is the distance. Linear codes, all the all zero code words is always a code word. In any linear code, all zeros, etc., is a code word. A linear code, any linear combination of code words is also a code word. For example, if we have code word C1 and code word C2, if we add them mod 2, then C sum is also code word in C. The distance D of the linear code is the minimum weight of its non-zero code words, or equivalently, the minimum distance between two different code words. D min equal minimum, the code word with minimum weight. Or, for example, for 3 parity matrix, we have 3 information bits and 1 parity. For the odd parity, you know, we generate here 1, 0, 0, 1, 0, 1, 1, 0. And we have the even parity matrix here. So here 0, 1, 1, 0, 1, 0, 0, 1. Are these two codes linear? First, you should know that the odd parity matrix does not contain a zero code word. This is one thing, while the even parity contains a zero word. So the odd parity code does not satisfy this condition, and hence it is not linear. And another thing, if we take, for example, in the odd parity C1 plus C2, C1 0 0 1 0 and C2 0 1 0 0 0 1 1 0. Do we have this word in this code? 0 1 1 0? No. But again, if we take C1, we take C1 and C2 in the even parity code and we add them by mod 2, 0, 1, 1, 0. This is a valid code word in even parity code. And try to add any two code words, you receive a valid code word in the even parity code. And the distance, now we proved that odd parity code is not linear code. Even parity code is a linear code. Now regarding the distance, if you take any two code words, for example, C4, 1001, and C5, 1010. If you add them, 1100. So the distance is the weight of the sum. The weight of 0011 equals 2. And this is the distance between C4 and C5. So distance between CI and CJ in a linear code is equals to the weight of their sum. But remember, always mode 2, exclusive OR. Exclusive OR. And again, this condition does not hold for all the code combinations in the odd parity code. Next, we move to the generator matrix G. Generator matrix G in linear codes is used to generate code words. If C is an NK code, then the size of G will be a matrix of this matrix. K rows, K rows, and N columns, N columns. So the size of the matrix equals K by N, K the number of information bits, and N is the length of the code word. For example, if we have again the 74 Hamming code, the G equals 2. Number of rows equals 4. Number of columns equals 7. It's 4 by 7. And we have identity matrix 4 by 4. The identity matrix in this case 1 0 0 0 0 1 0 0 0 0 1 0 0 0 1. So this is the first part here in G in the 74 Hamming code, and the other part is the parity check matrix. Parity check here I identity matrix, parity check matrix. So G equals to identity matrix and a matrix combined with parity check matrix. So the size of parity check matrix here you see is 4. Here we have 4. And here the remaining are N minus K. The size of parity check matrix is usually number of rows or K N minus K. The code C is the set of all linear combinations of the rows of G, or as we usually call it, the row space of G. So given the matrix G, the code C is obtained by multiplying G by all possible 1 by K row vectors information bits. This gives all possible linear combinations, or we say the code word table. C, in general, equals I, information words, and G, generator matrix. So we obtain the code words. For example, find the code words for 63 code with the generator matrix given. This is G. And as you see, in the 63 code, we have 3 rows and 6 columns. And the first 3 columns are the identity matrix, and the second part is the parity check matrix for the 63 code. To find C1, for example, we multiply 0 0 0 by the generator matrix 0, 0, 0 multiplied by 1, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 0, 0, 1. And this is the parity check matrix 0, 1, 1, 1, 0, 1, 1, 1, 0 for the 63 code. Do you see it is easy to find that this is equals to 0, the code word. For example, to find C2 equals 001 equals 001, we multiply here 0 by 0, 0 by 0, and 1 by 0, 0. The vector by the second column, 0, 0, 0. And 1, we multiply 0, 0, 1 by 0, 0, 1, the result is 1, since 0 by 0, 0 by 0, and 1 by 1, 1. Next, we multiply 0, 0, 1 by 0, 1, 1. And again, this gives us 1. And by this, again, it gives us 1. And last thing, 0 by 0, 0. And here, the last zeros, so we have 0, 0. This is C2. In 63 code, you can continue finding all C 4. For example, here we multiply 0, 1, 0 by the generator matrix C4. Again, by the generator matrix, etc., to obtain the all the code words. The number of code words in the 63 code, do you see we have valid code words? We have only 8. Why? Because 2 to the power 3 is 8. And these are the code words for 63 code. These are the valid code words. Two notes. First, if you multiply 0, 0, 1 or any 3 bits, the first 3 bits will be the same, since here we have identity matrix. If I multiply, for example, 101 by this, the first 3 bits will be 101, and the others depending on the parity matrix. The second thing, in the 63 code, we can generate in theory, which is equal 64, states, but the valid of are only 16. So 48 code combinations are not valid in the 63 code, and this helps us in finding or correcting an error. If the received code word is one of these, we should find from which code combination it has come. We'll see that. Next, the generator matrix for example, the 74 code. In the 74 code, in the generator matrix we have here, this is the generator matrix. Here we have the identity matrix, and here we have the parity matrix for the 7-4 code. As you see again, 4 rows and 7 columns. The I is 4 by 4 identity matrix, and the P is 4 by 7 minus 4, 3 columns. To find the code word for the information bit, we multiply C by the generator matrix. Here, 1 by 1, 1, 0 by 0, 0, 0, and 0. So the first is 1. Next, we multiply this by the second column to obtain the second bit, and multiply this vector by the third column to obtain the third bit, etc. So finally, this is our code word. For these information bits, this is the encoding process, giving the information bit in 7-4 code. Now we find the corresponding code word 7 bits. And another example, for example, if we have C equals to, here we have G. Again, we multiply this vector by the first column and to find the first bit, by the second column to find the next bit, etc. And you note, as in the previous example, here we have 1001. The first bits are 1001. Since this part is the identity matrix. So again, for this part, you can directly write that this 1101 and continue the process of finding these bits by multiplying this vector by this column, and next by next this column, and next by this column. Here I have, we have the generator matrix G in the 7-4 Hamming code. We have valid 2^4 16 code words valid. But invalid, since the length of the code is 7, so 2^7 minus the valid, which is equal 128 minus 116, and we have 112 invalid code words in the 7-4. Again, if the received code word is one of these, the process of correcting error reveals to finding from which valid code word this invalid has come. Here we have the table. These are the code words, C1, C2, C3, and you can start from C0, really, C16, and this is the corresponding code word for each. You can check if this is a linear code. First, we have a 0 code word. Second, the minimum weight is 3. You can check that. So this code is capable of correcting one error, and the sum of any two code words equals to the weight of the sum. Since the distance is three, the minimum distance is three, so we can correct one error. Do you remember, in order to correct C errors, the distance D should equal or should be equal or greater than 2C plus 1. Here we have D, the minimum, 3, 2C plus 1 means that C equals 1. We can correct one error and really detect two errors. Now, in the receiving end, for decoding, we use parity check matrix at this is a generator matrix of the dual code C. This means that a code word C, small, in C, if and only if the matrix vector H C is equals to zero. The rows of a parity check matrix are the coefficients of the parity check equations. That is, they show how linear combinations of certain digits components of each code word equals to zero. If we have here the H parity check matrix, this represents C1 plus C3 equals to zero, and C2 plus C4 equals to zero. That must be satisfied for the vector C1, C2, C3, C4 to be a valid code word of C. Now we go to the process of decoding. If the word, received word, is without errors, decoding a Hamming code word would be very easy. Just we throw the parity bits. For example, 1011 was decoded to this code word. In the receiving end, if we receive 1011100, and there was no errors during transmission, we just drop this part, and this is our valid or sent information bits. Now, what if we receive a code with an error and one or more parity bits are wrong? From G, parity check matrix can be constructed as follows. H is the parity check matrix. BT is the transpose of the parity matrix. P, remember, parity matrix. BT is a transpose, followed by identity matrix. The size of H is n minus k by n. The size of I is n minus k by n minus k. H, the parity check matrix, is used at the decoding stage to determine the error syndrome of the received code word. Now we have the generator matrix, for example, for 63 code. Do you see here is the identity matrix, and here is the parity check matrix for the 63 code. How to find the parity check matrix? here we have the transpose of B. B transpose, you see 011 in row to column 011, the second row 101 to column 101, the third row of B 110 to column 110. So this part, this is the whole H, this part is B transpose. In the remaining three columns, we have the identity matrix, 3x3. So this is the parity check matrix, 2, 4, 6, 3 code. Now, let's try to find a received code word multiplied by H transpose. This is H. Do you see this is here? H transpose. 011, the first row, 101, the second row, 110, the third row, 100, 010, 001, the last row. This is H transpose. Here. And we have received this code word. If we multiply again, we multiply this by the first column to receive the first bit, 0000, result 0, here 1, and here 1. So 2 ones, the remaining are zeros. 2 1 added together by mod 2, 0. Again, we multiply this by the second column, 2 zeros. Here we have 1, 0, here 1. Again, 2 ones, 0. And the this vector by multiplied by the last column, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0. We'll have the answer here, 0. Why this? Because this is a valid code word. Is 00100, is it a valid code word? 00310, here we have it. Do you see? If we receive a valid code word, an invalid code word, and multiply it by H transpose, then the error syndrome, we call this syndrome, always is equal to zero. This is another example. This is another valid code word. And this is H transpose. If you multiply and you see 111, 00, this is in the 63 code. If you multiply this by the first row, the first column, you will have 11 added together 0. By the second column, you will have 1 and here 1, together 0. And here 11, and all the remaining zeros together 0. So the error syndrome is 0, meaning that this code word was received correctly without any errors. Here, this is our code word. This is H transpose. The original one here, but I did a mistake in this bit. If we multiply by the first, this vector by the first column will have 0. I did it. And by the second, we'll again have zero. And if we multiply it by the third column, we'll have one. So the error syndrome equals to 001. Now how to correct this error? We should look where is the 001 here. It is here. So the error vector is 0000, and here one on this part. Now we can add 111001 with the error vector 100. Do you see in the error vector you should have only one and all the remaining here we have 0, 0. No carry because mod 2. 0, 1, 1, 1. And this is the correct without errors after correcting the error code word. Here is another example. We have again, this is H transpose, and this is the received code word, but with error here. Actually, we don't know where is the error, but for demo purposes, we multiply it by the first column. Here we have one. By the second column, we'll have zero, and by the third column, we'll have zero. So this is the error syndrome. Now, where is in the H transpose 100? It is here. So the error vector is 0, 0, 1, 0, 1, 0, 0. This is the error vector. We should add it to the received word, or as you see, we should complement this bit, and after complementing it, we receive 010101, and this is our correct after correction, the error in that bit, correct code word. Now the same, now it's easier for you. Parity check matrix, for example, 474, Hamming code. Remember, parity check matrix is the transpose of parity combined with identity matrix. Now we have the generator. Remember, generator matrix 4G. Here is the parity. Parity transpose equal to 1, 1, 1, 0 in the first row, 0, 1, 1, 1 in the second row, 1, 1, 0, 1. So this is parity transpose. Now to generate H, we have here parity transpose. And here the identity matrix 3 by 3. So this is H 474 Hamming code. Now H transpose equals to, do you see 1, 1, 1, 0, 1, 0, 0 in the first column? Trace with me the second column. 0, 1, 1, 1, 0, 1, 0 in the second column, and 1, 1, 0, 1, 0, 0, 1 in the third column. So this is H transpose, and now we can use it for decoding and finding the error syndrome. For example, this, the H. I did it. And this is the edge. I just brought them here. And I brought the Hamming table for all the valid code words. Now, if we have the code word received, here we have H transpose. If we multiply them, we multiply this vector by the first column to obtain zero, and this vector by the second column again zero, and this column by the third, this row or vector by the third column again zero. Zero, zero, zero error syndrome, no errors. So these are our information bits, the four, directly. And is this a valid code word in 7-4 code? You can check 1111. This is, it is a valid code word. You can take another example. You can pick any valid code word from this. Now I pick this one, code word, yes. And here we have H transpose. If we multiply this vector by the first column, we'll get zero. With the second column, again zero. With the third column, again zero. So the error syndrome is zeros, meaning that we haven't any errors, and these are our information bits. Suppose this is H transpose, another example, but with errors. And here we have received code word, and this is H transpose. If we multiply the received vector by the first column, you can check it, we obtain here one, by the second column, one, and by the third column, again one. 111 is the error syndrome. Where is 111? It is here. So in the error vector, we have one here, and on the others, we have zero. Now, if you add 1010100 with the error vector 01, all then you have 111100. This is the correct code word without error, and this is our part, the information bits. So 1110 here, and this is, do you see, we send this one, but error occurs here. So we could define or find out from where this received code word most probably came. Another example, if we receive this code word, we multiply again it by, this is the received, you see, with the error, and this is H transpose for 7-4 Hamming code. If we multiply, and I think it's easy for you now, this is the error syndrome. Zero, 011. We have here 011, so the error vector will be, and all this is the error vector. If if you add it to the received code word, you will correct the error. And directly, this corresponds to this bit. So adding one will inverse the state of this bit and correct the error. This is another example, and please, by yourself, look at it. This is H transpose. Again, received code word with error. This is the error syndrome. It is here. And directly, this is the error vector. But directly, you can see on the in this bit. By inversing it, we receive the correct code word. This was an introduction to linear codes with the examples, how to generate the generator matrix, parity matrix, how to obtain all the valid code words, and in the receiving end, how to correct errors if they were met. Thank you for watching.